Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, now we are going to talk about the topic alkenes and its classification. So in this lecture we are going to learn about the definition of the alkene as well as the general formula of the alkene as well as the classification of alkenes also. So let us try about them. So friends, here we are going to talk about alkenes and its classification. So before learning about its classification, let us understand what is actually alkene. So alkene is, or alkenes are, the unsaturated hydrocarbons containing one or more carbon-carbon double bond. Or we could say that these are the aliphatic hydrocarbons which consist of one or more carbon-carbon double bond. And the general formula in this case is basically, that is in case of alkenes, are basically CnH2n. But earlier we have made a lecture on alkenes, and in that case we have got to know that the general formula of alkenes are basically CnH2n+2. But now we are talking about alkenes, so in this case CnH2n is the general formula of alkenes, having two hydrogen less than compared to that of the general formula of the alkenes. So let us try this with an example and let us see whether this is the formula that has been obeying in all the alkenes or not when it comes to aliphatic hydrocarbons. So the first example to give the first member of an alkene is basically ethene, and this could be written as this is the name which ends with the suffix ene, which clearly indicates that this would be the alkene, because the IUPAC name is also that we are going to do in our next lecture. But just by the last suffix that we have seen in this name or in this nomenclature, we could predict that this would be the alkene. And moreover, we could see that there is carbon-carbon double bond in this case, so that's the reason that it is an alkene and it is an unsaturated hydrocarbon. And now let us talk about the general formula. So the general formula that we have got to know, it was basically CnH2n, where N represents the number of carbon atom that is present in that hydrocarbon. So in this hydrocarbon, the total number of carbon here is basically C. So C2H2 into 2, because we are following the formula, that is 2 into N, that is the reason we'll get the formula to be CnH2 into 2, basically it's 4, and that is nothing but the ethene. So that is the reason that it has been following the formula CnH2n. So let us try out the another example that we could make, that is this one. So suppose this is the structure that we have, and for talking about the name of this thing, then since it contains of three carbon atom, and three carbon atoms in terms of alkane, saturated hydrocarbon, are known as basically propane. But this is unsaturated hydrocarbon, and as well as the carbon-carbon double bond has been existed between these two carbon atoms. So that is the reason it will be called as propene, and specifically it will be named as prop1-ene. So let us see whether this is following the general formula or not. Suppose the total number of carbon in this case is basically, if I divide these two things, so this is basically three carbon atoms that we will get, and if it follows CnH2n, so therefore the number of carbon atom is basically in this case is 3, so 2 into 3, it should be basically C3H6. So let us see whether there are total six hydrogen atoms or not, along with three carbon atoms. So here it is, three carbon atoms along with basically six hydrogen atoms. So therefore this is called to be, or this is following the general formula of alkene, and basically this is known as propene. And again you could see that it ends with ene, which states that this is basically an unsaturated hydrocarbon that contains carbon-carbon double bond, known as alkene. So this was the basically the general formula that we have did. But yes, there are also the classifications of this alkene. But moreover, we could see that it is not necessary that an alkene will consist of only one carbon-carbon double bond. It could consist of more or multiple carbon-carbon double bonds. So for that, let me explain you. Suppose if we have a molecule like, and this one. So even this is alkene, and we could see that there are carbon-carbon double bond and more carbon-carbon double bond. Here it is 2 carbon-carbon double bond, while here in this case we could see 3 carbon-carbon double bonds. So these are not the classification, but these are the only types of alkenes that we are going to talk about. So in this case, what we could see, that there is carbon-carbon double bond, and moreover we could see that there are 2 basically carbon-carbon double bonds, making this to be generally called as alkydienes. While in this case, because as we could see that there is 3 carbon-carbon double bonds, making this to be generally called as alkydienes. So the name of this would be, because the IUPAC name is the separate lecture that we are going to take about. So for an instance, suppose the name of this would be called as, because there are 4 carbon atoms, and we could see that the carbon number will be starting from that carbon atom, which will consist of a very close carbon-carbon double bond, or we could say the numbering will start from that carbon atom, where we could see that the double bond will get basically the least number. So therefore, this would be the first, second, third, and fourth, making to have basically 4 carbon atoms in a straight chain. And we could see that 4 carbon atoms in term of alkanes are basically called as butane, but this is not butane, this is basically an alkene. So therefore, the name of this would be buta 1,2-diene. So this is the name of the structure that I have made. And talking about this structure, then structure will have a nomenclature in this format, having a numbering from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And since 5 carbon atoms are present in this molecule, making this to be called as basically pentane when it is basically a saturated hydrocarbon, basically an alkane. But this is not an alkane, this is alkene. So therefore, the name of this would be penta 1,2,3-triene. So this is the name of these 2 alkanes, and these are the alkanes which consist of multiple carbon-carbon double bonds. So therefore, the name, for generalization, the name of this one would be basically alkydiene, and while this one will be alkytriene, showing that there are basically 2 carbon-carbon double bonds here, and there are basically 3 carbon-carbon double bonds here. So this was a general types that we have did for alkene, and this could be possible because, as we have mentioned in the definition also, that could be one or more carbon-carbon double bond. Now let's come back to the classification of alkenes. So that is a very important thing to learn about, that what are the classification of alkenes. So let us talk about that. So now we are going to talk about the classification of alkenes. Alkenes are basically divided into 2 parts. So that is what I am going to explain. The first one is basically symmetrical alkenes, and the second one is unsymmetrical alkenes. So these are the 2 things that I am going to talk about. That is, the first is symmetrical alkene, and the next is unsymmetrical alkene. So what is the difference between 2, and what are actually this type of classification of alkenes? So let me talk about separately about the first one, that is symmetrical alkenes. So talking about the first one, that is so symmetrical alkenes are the alkenes in which there are 2 same group that are being attached to the carbon-carbon double bond. For example, if this is the carbon bond, carbon-carbon double bond, if I have or if I have made, and by classifying this thing, so if I get the 2 same groups or same kind of atoms that are being attached to the carbon-carbon double bond. Suppose in this case, suppose this is the carbon-carbon double bond, if I have mentioned here, and in one side, suppose if I have got a CH3 group, and while on the other side also, suppose if I have got a CH3 group, and in this case suppose hydrogen atom is been present, and here also the hydrogen group is been present. So in this case, this would be called as basically the symmetrical alkene. The reason behind that is, suppose if I divide or if I try to distribute these 2 carbon atoms in such a manner, and that should be divided in the carbon-carbon double bond itself, through the carbon-carbon double bond. And in this case, what I could see is the total number of methyl group, which is on the left hand side, as you could see, is 1, and that of on the right hand side is also 1. And talking about the another group, that is or another atom that I am talking about, that is hydrogen, in the left hand side is, here it is 1 hydrogen, and here in this case also it is 1 hydrogen independently, which has been directly attached to the this carbon atom. So that is what I am going to talk about. So now this is the molecule where I could see that this is basically a symmetrical alkene. The reason behind that is, as I have mentioned earlier also, because the two it should consist of two similar groups that are being attached to the carbon-carbon double bond. So in this case, this is basically known as symmetrical alkene. But let me give us the name also, because we are going to talk about the IUPAC nomenclature in our future lecture. So let us talk about the name. So the nomenclature would be very much easy to understand. So let me give you a small glimpse of it. So the number, we start from that carbon atom where we could get the carbon-carbon double bond to get a very least number. So since there is a symmetrical molecule, and so therefore the numbering can be given from any side. So therefore, suppose this is the first carbon, second, third and fourth. So in this case, basically four carbon atoms are been present in a straight chain, just as the rule of the alkane, and the carbon-carbon double bond is present, or it starts from the carbon number 2. So that's the reason the name of this would be, even in terms of alkane, it would be basically butane, but this is not butane, this is butane. The reason behind that is it is an alkene, and moreover the position of the carbon-carbon double bond is at it starts from second carbon atom, so therefore making the name of this to be called as butane. So this is the name of the alkene, and moreover we have got to know that this is basically symmetrical alkene. So now let us talk about the another classification that we are going to talk about, and that are, and that is basically unsymmetrical alkene. So now we are going to talk about unsymmetrical alkene. Just like the previous one, it will have a difference, because the previous one, what we have got to know, that there will be similar groups that would be attached to the carbon-carbon double bond. But in this case, it would be different from that. The definition of this would be, it would contain different groups that are been attached to the carbon-carbon double bond. For example, suppose this is the carbon-carbon double bond that I have mentioned over here, and suppose in this case, suppose if I have mentioned or if I have made to attach a CH3 or methyl group, and H is also present here, and in this case basically H is present over here. So suppose in this case, suppose if I have divided this group, then in this case I won't get similar groups, I would get hydrogen, that is fine, I would get hydrogen, but this would not be called as the symmetrical alkene. The reason behind that is because if I divide this, or if I divide this carbon-carbon double bond in this way, so as I could see, on the left hand side I could get one hydrogen, but on the same, on the right hand side I got CH3. So these two atoms are, or these two groups are basically different, and in this case these two are basically are having the same atoms, that is hydrogen and hydrogen. But still, this won't be called as the symmetrical alkene, because this is unsymmetrical alkene, and there are different groups, at least one you could see, there is one difference that you could see between the that have been attached to the carbon-carbon double bond. So one consists of a methyl group while the other consists of a hydrogen group, but in this case they are similar, but yes, we could find a difference. But in the earlier lecture, in the earlier structure that we have drawn, we can't find a difference, and that's the reason this was called to be a symmetrical alkene, while this is basically unsymmetrical alkene. So these are the two differences. But talking about the nomenclature, let me give the nomenclature of this also. So we should decide the longest chain, and this is the longest chain that we will get. And talking about the numbering, so numbering will start from that carbon atom which will get at least number of the carbon-carbon double bond from where it starts. So therefore this would be carbon number 1. This is 2, while this is 3. So since there are 3 carbon atoms, making this to be called as propane. But this is not a alkane, this is basically alkene. So we will name this as called to be prop. And since the carbon-carbon double bond starts from the position number 1, or the carbon number 1, the name of this would be prop-1-ene. So these were the two classifications where we have understood that one among that would be a symmetrical alkene, and the other kind of the classification is basically unsymmetrical alkenes. So basically all the alkenes have been distributed in this manner. And talking about the symmetry of the thing, this would be also be talked in our next lecture that we are going to take. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and you have also got to know that is what is alkenes and what are the general formula of alkenes, and yes, what are the types of or classification of alkenes that we have studied. So thank you friends for watching this video. Share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.